The context window allows you to control exactly what pieces of knowledge the AI has about your project. Now, if you have nothing selected in this window, then by default, when you prompt something to the AI, it will know about the elements on your page. So for example, if I asked it to add a blue header to the page, then it's able to do so because it has context of what elements are on the page and what the styling of those elements currently are. However, if I wanted to set up some kind of logic so that when I press this Our Collection header, it triggers this Send to Email Global workflow I have, it likely won't achieve this. So if I select the element and then view the workflow that it created, I can see it hasn't set it up to use that Send to Email workflow. And this is because it doesn't have context of that Send to Email workflow. It only knows about the core elements on the page and their styling properties. So to get around this, we can utilize the context window. Now, when we choose full project context, this does exactly as it says. It passes in our entire project as context. So all of the elements, all of our workflows, all of our variables, absolutely everything. Now this has its pros and cons. Pros are that the AI will obviously have context of everything. So if you ask it to use a variable, ask it to use a piece of logic, it will know exactly what you're talking about. However, the cons are if your project is extremely large, it may simply be too much for the AI to handle, in which case you might see an error if your project is too large. But also, even if your project isn't too large, sometimes you can simply overload the AI with context. If you know exactly what you want the AI to work with, then it's always better to pass in those specific pieces of context as opposed to just giving it absolutely everything and potentially giving it unnecessary pieces of context. Now for the other options, you have all pop-ups. With this selected, it will pass in any pop-ups you've created inside of your project and all their associated logic. You then have all project workflows, and this will pass in any project level workflows you've created inside of the logic tab. Then all project formulas. This will pass in any project level formulas you've created inside of the logic tab. And then you have these two last options, page dependencies and selected element dependencies. Now, if you're unsure what a dependency is, it basically means any pieces of data or logic that are used by those elements. So in the case of page dependencies, if you have page dependencies selected, it will pass in all of the elements of the page, but it will also pass in any logic or data that that page uses. So for example, it would pass in any formulas, any workflows, any pop-ups, any variables or any collections used by any of the elements on the page. And then likewise, you have selected element dependencies, and this operates the same as the page dependencies. However, instead of passing in everything on the page, it will only pass in the elements you have selected and any of their respective dependencies. And then outside of these broad options, you have the specific tabs where you can choose exactly what you want to pass in. Now, in the example I used at the start, I wanted the AI to set up a workflow so that on press of our collection, it would trigger this send to email project level workflow. In this case, since I know exactly what I want the AI to do and exactly what dependencies there are, I could pass in those dependencies as context manually. So I could click onto the Our Collection text element to pass it in as context. And then in the Project Workflows tab, I could pass in the Send to Email workflow so the AI has context of it. Now, if I try the same prompt again, it's far more likely to work because it has that scoped context. So I can send off my prompt. And now if I go into edit mode and check the workflow of the text element, I can see it's set up to use that send to email workflow. So to summarize, if you're ever unsure exactly what to pass in as context to the AI, then it's always recommended to pass in the full project context. However, if your project is extremely large and you experience poor results, perhaps because the AI then has too much context, then it's recommended to either select page dependencies or selected element dependencies. And if you want to get extremely granular, then you could choose all pop-ups, all project workflows, or all project formulas, or even navigate to the respective tabs and pass in exactly the data points that you want.